الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد Dear students and friends assalam alaikum आज हम पाकिस्तान स्टडी से रिलेटेड टॉपिक पाकिस्तान कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल हिस्ट्री 1956 टू 1973 को डिस्कस करने वाले हैं सो लेट्स स्टार्ट Topic of discussion and our view of the constitutional and a little bit political history of Pakistan from 1956 to 1973. Abrogation of 1956 constitution and imposition of martial law 1958. Everyone knows no election were held after the enforcement of the constitution 1956. In 1956, Constitution was abrogated on October 7, 1958. It worked from March 23, 1956 to October 7, 1958. As military took over and resultantly Mr. Ayub Khan became the Chief Martial Law Administrator. Introduction of basic democracies by the Mr. Ayub Khan 1959. In October 1959, basic democracies was introduced under the system. 40,000 basic democrat local councillor were to be elected in each federating unit. Election for the basic democracies BD were held in December 1959 and January 1960. Moreover, the presidential referendum was held by the elected BD's member on February 17, 1960. A constitution commission was established in 1960 February under the chairmanship of Justice Shahabuddin a former Chief Justice of Pakistan. This above mentioned commission presented its report in May 1961 and then two committees reviewed it. Mr. Ayub announced the constitution on March 1, 1962. Election to be National Assembly and the Provincial Assemblies were held in April and May 1962 respectively. The second constitution was imposed on June 8, 1962. Resultantly, the martial law was withdrawn. Written constitution consists of 250 articles which were divided into 12 parts and 3 schedules. Party rigid and the party flexible, National Assembly with 2-on-3 majority or 2/3 majority with the concurrence of the president with the certain exception. Federal system in later, but the spirit close to unitary system is appointment of provincial government and the minister were to be made by the president. President system, but with certain features of parliamentary system. Unicameral legislature seat according to the ratio of population. In direct election, only 80,000 basic democrats were given the right to vote in the presidential election. Judiciary judges of the Supreme Court were appointed by the president and ensure security of the service. Islamic provision reinsertion after public reaction. Political parties. Originally, political parties were not allowed. Political Parties Act was introduced in 1962. Fundamental rights and principle of policy by First Amendment in 1963. Abrogation of the 1962 Constitution on March 25, 1969 led to the second martial law in that country. Mr. Yahya Khan on December 1970 held the first general election on the basis of one man, one rule. Awami League got a sweeping victory in the election of an National Assembly and that of the Provincial Assembly in East Pakistan, whereas the Pakistan People Party emerged as the biggest party in the West Pakistan. East Pakistan crisis, war continued between both countries till 17 of December 1971, when Pakistan Army surrendered on East Pakistan front. Mr. Yahya Khan handed over the power to the Zulfikar Ali Bhutto on 20 December 1971. But martial law continued and there was no constitution. National Assembly approved an interim constitution which was enforced on April 21, 1972. On 14 August 1973, new constitution was enforced. Islamic Republic of Pakistan. These are the silent features of 1973's constitution, Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Written and partially flexible, the constitution comprised 280 articles and 6 schedules. The parliament is authorized to amend it by 2/3 majority. Islamic provisions. The inclusion of Islamic provisions was given the 1973 constitution an unprecedented Islamic character. The name Islamic Republic of Pakistan is selected for the state of Pakistan. Islam is declared as the state of the religion. Steps shall be taken to enable the Muslim Pakistan individually or collectively to order their life in accordance with the fundamental principle and the basic concept of Islam. Steps shall be taken to make the teaching of the Quran and Islamiyat compulsory, the encourage and the facilitate the learning of Arabic language and to secure correct and exact printing and publishing of the Quran. Proper organization of zakat, waqaf and mosque ensured. Only a Muslim could be qualified for election as a president, male or female, and prime minister, male or female. The state shall prevent prostitution, gambling, and consumption of alcohol, printing, publication, circulation, and display of obscene literature and advertisement. All existing laws shall be brought in the conformity with the injunction of Islam as laid down in the Quran and Sunnah, and no law shall be enacted which is repugnant to such injunctions. A Council of Islamic Ideology shall be constituted, referred to as the Islamic Council. The function of the Islamic Council shall be to take recommendation to the Parliament and the Provincial Assemblies about the ways and means of enabling and encouraging the Muslim of the Pakistan and order their lives in accordance with the principle of Islam. For the first time, the Constitution of Pakistan gave definition of a Muslim, which stated that Muslim means a person who believes in the unity of oneness of Allah, in the absolute and unqualified finality of the prophethood of the Islamic prophet Muhammad, and does not believe in or recognize as a prophet or religious reformer. Any person who claimed or claims to be a prophet in any sense of the word or of any description whatever after Muhammad, peace be upon him, federal system. According to the division of the power, the federal and in current affairs have been expressed in two distinct lists, while residuary powers are assigned to the state. Provincially, autonomy has been fully ensured along with a strong central government. Nowadays, the federal government is authorized to the intervene in the ordinary circumstances during emergency conditions. In the intervention is further expanded. Presidential rule can be announced in any province in the cause of failure of a provincial government. 1973's constitution, the president active and power head of the state qualification. He must be at least 45 years. He should be a Muslim. He must be qualified to the elected as member of National Assembly. Term of office 5 years. Parliamentary system. President act as the head of the state. Prime Minister, head of the government, shall select the term of his ministers and the member of parliament, and at least 1/4 of them shall be taken from the Senate. Under an amendment of the Constitution, a balance has been secured between the power of the President and those of the Prime Minister, while giving power to the President to dissolve the Assembly on his direction, a discretion under the Article 52B. This power was taken back by 13th Amendment but reinserted in Constitution by 17th Amendment. However, the 18th Amendment has again taken back his power from the President by the Zardari Sahab and Pakistan People's Party. Parliament Majlis-e-Shura. The Parliament of Pakistan, according to the Constitution of 73, is bicameral. Article 50 of the Constitution clearly states that the Parliament of the Pakistan consists of the President and two House known as the National Assembly and the Senate. National Assembly, under Article 51, it is consists of 342 general seats, 60 reserved seats for women and 10 for minorities. According to Election Commission of Pakistan, who is playing a great role in making of government distribute the country into 272 National Assembly seats. Starting from NA1 Peshawar till NA272 Kutch cum Gwadar. FATA 12, Federal Capital 2, KPK 35, Punjab 148, Sindh 61, Balochistan 14 seats. Senate, Upper House, 1973's Constitution. Senate, the Senate of Pakistan is the upper house of the bicameral parliament of Pakistan. The Constitution does not give the President of Pakistan the authority to dissolve the Senate unlike the National Assembly. If the office of the President of Pakistan become vacant or the President is unable to perform his function, the Chairman of the Senate acts as the President until a President is elected. The government of General Pervez Musharraf raised the membership of the Senate from 87 to 100 in 2002. Equal representation of all federating units. Qualification for Senator, 1973 Constitution. Qualification for a Senator, one candidate. A candidate for the seat of the Senate should be at least 30 years old, and for National Assembly 25 years to the minimum. He must be a citizen of Pakistan, lunatics, bankrupt and traitors are deprived of membership. Judiciary, 1973's Constitution. Judiciary, single series of courts, separate court at the lower level for the civil and criminal cases. Supreme Court at the apex, it enjoys original appellate and advisory jurisdiction. Removal. Judge of the Superior Courts can be removed by the President on the basis of inquiry conducted by the Supreme Judicial Council on the charges of gross misconduct or physical mental unfitness. Superior Courts can be declared such laws or decrees invalid as are against the Constitution. Federal Sharia law has been established to judge the validity of laws in the light of Sharia. Election. All the legislative assemblies are elected directly by the people on the basis of adult suffrage through the single member of constitution of constituencies and by secret ballot. Whereas the president and the senator are to be elected by an electoral college. Election commission conduct the whole election process. Fundamental rights. All the fundamental rights have been incorporated in the form of a list in the constitution and these are to be enforced through Superior Court. These can, however, be suspended during emergency. Local electoral bodies will be set up for the solving local problems. The provincial and other judges shall be discouraged. The women shall be given full representation in all spheres of the national life. Social justice shall be promoted. Bond with Muslim board shall be strengthened. Multiple party system. Urdu as its national Islam language, but English retained as the official language for 15 years, date term has been extended. Single citizenship, abrogation of the constitution as high treason, referendum. 18th amendment of the constitution of Pakistan 1973-2010. This amendment was passed by the National Assembly of Pakistan on April 8, 2010, removing the power of the President of Pakistan to dissolve the parliament in order to turn Pakistan from a semi-presidential to a parliamentary republic. 18th amendment removes the limit on a prime minister serving more than two terms, renaming Northwest Frontier Province to Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Among other changes, court will no longer be able to endorse suspension of the constitution. A judiciary commission will appoint judges and the president will no longer be able to appoint the head of the election commission. The bill also enhanced provincial autonomy. The provincial autonomy, the president will no longer be able to declare emergency rule in any province unilaterally. The Constitution 19th Amendment Act 2010. This was the preview of Constitution of Pakistan 1956 to 1973. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.